suit after instituting gets numbered, how it gets classified, because the suits are normally predominantly or of two categories. When you go from into the court of law, there is a register in every court of law, civil court of law, which classifies suits only into two categories. One is suits relating to your assertion of rights of various kinds, and the other is money suits, where your claim is only in respect of money. You're claiming your money. And so the suits are basically numbered in that register, which is classified into A and B. If your suit is classified under classification A, that means your assertion of rights of various kinds, and B classification is exclusively for money suits, where your claim is only for money, recovery of money. Right? So, the formula is moving ahead. Now your plaint is ready and it has been instituted in the court of law. Once it is instituted in a court of law, what would happen? What would the court do? Inform the other party. Kya naam hai aapka? I'm sorry? Dr. Patel. Wow, Dr. Saab. Law mein bhi itni badhiya samajh. Taali bajaiye, Dr. Saab. Once the suit is instituted, the other party has to be informed. And where will you inform the other party? Under order 5. Order 5 talks about issue and service of summons. Issue and service of summons. Summon jari ho gaya dusri party ko. Theek hai? All the rules of issue and service of summons is given under order 5. So, now the other party is also being notified that some claim has been made against him in such and such court of law, where he has to appear and defend his cause. Is it clear? Who notifies the other side? The court notifies, issues summons. Who issues the summons? The court. Because once you have instituted your suit, the court is issuing summons to the other side. Is it very clear up to now?
Yes, sir.
So basically, we have reached from 1 to 35A sections and order 1 to 7. Isn't it? Order 1 to 7 complete, no fill in the blanks. Shall I rub this? And will you repeat that the whole procedure now? Please. Who will repeat? Just tell me. Who will repeat? Yes. This girl. Stand up. Tell them all.
Section 935A plus order 1A. Section 26 plus order 4 is for institution of suits. Order 5 is for summons.
No. How the plaint has been made in different orders? Explain all those orders. Order from 1 to 7.
1 to 7. Hmm. It would be parties to the suit, order 1. Framing of the suit, order 2. Then the recognized agents and pleaders, order 3. Then it would be pleadings in general. Order 6, and then it would be institution of suit.
No, where have the plaint gone? What are you instituting? Order 7 is plaint, then you institute, and then issue of summons under order 5. Sit down, thank you, clap for. Who else? That boy last. Yes, yes, you. Tell me, all the orders.
7 is for institution for making of suit. From section 9 to 35A, then section 26 plus order 4 is for institution of suit, and order 5 is for issue of summons.
1, 2, 7, explain all orders. Dhyan nahi hai. Last girl. Yes, yes, last girl. Stand up. Behind this black t-shirt. Where are you looking here and there? Yes, explain. You are for the? अरे तो कोई परेशानी है फर्स्ट ईयर में नॉलेज ले लो सीपीसी की व्हाट्स सो रॉन्ग यू आर गेटिंग नॉलेज या प्लीज सिट डाउन
ऑर्डर 1 वी हैव टू ब्लॉक इट यस हु विल बी द पार्टी टू द सूट्स द प्लेंटिफ एंड द डिफेंडेंट फॉर ऑर्डर 2 देयर इज फ्रेम ऑफ सूट्स लाइक हाउ द सूट इज टू बी मेड थर्ड इज रिकॉग्नाइज द एजेंट हु विल बी द लॉयर और द प्लीडर हु विल पुट इट बिफोर द कोर्ट Third is institution of the suit, that where the suit will be instituted. Fifth is issue of summon. And sixth is
you have gone in a sequence. That's why I'm saying that you have to see it in a different method. Not in that sequence of numbers, 1, 2, 6, 7 you have said. See, anyway, sit down. Please understand, again and again I'm telling you, don't read CPC as a novel or as some kind of after this order 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, it'll not make sense to you. You have to understand how a suit proceeds, how a suit is made, how your claim is asserted. And there is a method given, and that's why I'm giving you these tricks to read CPC. Once you understood the process of the suit, as a lawyer, you would not commit mistakes. You would know and you would be in a position to tell the court that this is the next step you have to take. Isn't it? Anyway, moving ahead. Now, up to this point, the plaintiff has been asserting his right before the court of law. So the plaintiff's plaint is now numbered, summons have been issued, the other side have been notified, and now the role of the other side begins. He has to appear before the court and submit his defense. And that defense in writing is called written statement order 8. Order 8 talks about written statement. Order 8 clarifies that the defendant has to, under Rule 1, it says that the defendant has to submit his written statement within 30 days from the date of service of summons. The date he received summons, within 30 days he has to file his written statement before the court of law. If he could not do it in 30 days, then he can seek an extension from the court up to 90 days only. With the permission of the court, he can file his written statement within 90 days from the date of service of summon upon him. But without permission, he can do only up to 30 days. Within 30 days, if he does, he does not require permission of the court. But if he crossed the 30 day and he wants to file it, he will have to seek the permission of the court explaining the delay. But that too, the limit has been prescribed up to 90 days. So as a lawyer of tomorrow, remember to file your written statement in first 30 days also, because that is your right. You're not even in the mercy of the court. Because once you cross 30 days, you will have to seek the permission of the court. And for seeking permission, the court may ask you reason. Why there is a delay? Why could not you file in time? So you are at the mercy of court. The court may say, no, your reasons are not justified. So why not assert your right within 30 days itself, which is your prerogative? So the moment the summons have been served, a client approaches you as a lawyer, sir, these summons have come to me. Prepare the written statement, within 30 days, file it. Is it clear? Order 8. Now, plaint has been replied by the defendant. So both parties are before the court. Isn't it? Kahani aage pad gayi? Written statement order 8 tak aa gayi? Then abhi to ye written statement ka document court ke paas aaya hai. Also maybe through that order 3, recognized agent and pleader of the defendant. Recognized agent and pleader of plaintiff hai, to udhar se bhi to hoga. So invoking order 3, written statement has come. You can couple order 3 with order 8 through a recognized agent or a pleader. Therefore, and consequences of non-appearance. If you do not appear before the court, what would happen? Ex parte order? Kya naam hai aapka? Karan Singh. Karan Singh keh rahe hain ki agar aap appear nahi honge, to ex parte order ho jayega. Kiske favor mein?
Plaintiff.
Aur plaintiff hi appear nahi hua to?
No.
To ex parte order defendant? क्या दूसरा क्या होगा? हाँ, करण सिंह जो हैं वो आधी बात कह रहे हैं, एक्स पार्टी ऑर्डर हो जाएगा. अरे भाई प्लेंटिफ ही अपीयर नहीं हुआ तो क्या होगा? हाँ, सूट विल बी डिसमिस्ड. तो करण सिंह आधी बात नहीं, एक्स पार्टी अकेला थोड़ी, डिसमिसल भी हो सकता है. दोनों पार्टी को आना है ना. अपियरेंस एंड कॉन्सिक्वेंसेज ऑफ नॉन अपियरेंस. ये नहीं कह रहा कि अपियरेंस एंड नॉन अपियरेंस ओनली ऑफ डिफेंडेंट. ऑर्डर 9 इज क्लियर. अपियरेंस एंड कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस ऑफ नॉन अपियरेंस इंक्लूड्स बोथ साइड्स. नाउ देयरफॉर इट इज इंपॉर्टेंट टू रिमेंबर दैट इन केस अ डिफेंडेंट डज नॉट अपियर, व्हाट करण सेज will be an ex parte order in the favor of the plaintiff. But if the plaintiff does not appear, then the suit will be dismissed for want of prosecution. Because the person who's claiming his right himself is not coming to court. Then the suit will be dismissed for want of prosecution. Now, suppose this happens, is there any remedy? जिस दिन तारीख थी उसी दिन आपकी तबीयत खराब हो गई, अपीयरेंस पॉसिबल नहीं, उसी दिन आपके किसी रिश्तेदार के यहां कोई दुर्घटना हो गई और आपको वहां जाना पड़ा, आपकी तबीयत ठीक थी उसकी तबीयत खराब हो गई, आप अपीयरेंस नहीं कर पा रहे, जिस दिन तारीख पड़ी उसी दिन आपके यहां बहुत बड़ा कोई फेस्टिवल है, ओकेजन है, शादी है, ब्याह है, बर्थडे है, आप नहीं जा सकते. बहुत सारा जीवन में घटनाक्रम होता है. और अगर आप नहीं गए और कॉन्सिक्वेंस हो गया, डिसमिसल हो गया या एक्स पार्टी हो गया, तो उसकी रेमेडी क्या है? भाई एक नॉन अपीयरेंस से पूरा क्लेम तो खत्म नहीं होना चाहिए, रीजनेबल नहीं लगता. इसलिए सेटिंग असाइड द एक्स पार्टी ऑर्डर और द डिसमिसल ऑर्डर,